Well, my name is Mike from AbleNet's Technical Support, and today we're going to show you how to create a board. So the first thing you'll want to do is open the application. Now, this is SoundingBoard version 4.1. This version of SoundingBoard has the ability to go portrait or landscape. As you can see right now, we're in landscape, so you have that freedom there. First things first, you'll notice that there are some preloaded boards in the application that you can't access right out of the gate. You can interact with them. They're already preloaded with messages and prompts, so you can access those. You'll notice a few different items here: add board, edit board, and then your menu options. What we're going to go over right now is basically how to create a board. So you'll go to add board. You can see the options that you have available here. You'll name the board, you'll select an image to represent the board, and then you can also record an audio prompt for the board for scanning purposes. So we'll go in here and name it AbleNet. And then we want to select an image for the board. You can pick from the symbols library of preloaded images inside the application. You can also pick from your photo library if you have a picture existing in the library that you've already downloaded to the iPad. Or you can choose to take a new photo. That will give you the opportunity to take a picture of whatever it is that you'd like to incorporate into the board. But for our purposes right now, we're going to pick from the symbols library so we can pick a preloaded image. And we'll just pick any image here, and we'll pick the Big Mac from AbleNet. And then I'll go ahead and record a prompt message just so it's there. Test 1, 2, 3. And then we can play that prompt message back.
Test 1, 2, 3.
To make sure that it took that message. Now, it's very important at this point to select the upper right-hand arrow so that we can proceed to adding our first message cell location. And this is basically what it would look like. You have the ability to add the image, so this would be your first cell. At this point, you'd tap right on the image, and now you have all the available options for the first cell. So again, you have adding an image, you name the cell, you can record your first message, and you can also record a prompt message, basically for, again, scanning purposes. And then link message to another board, that gives you the ability to navigate between different message boards. So what we'll do is add our first image here. Again, we're just going to pick from the symbols library. And I'll just pick animals and a cat. And then we'll hit save. And then we'll name the cell cat. And save again. And then we'll go to record message 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, test. And now we'll record the prompt message for that. Test 1, 2, 3. Now at this point you are able to save the board. The only things that are absolutely necessary to saving the board is the image, the message name, and a recorded message. You do not have to record the prompt message, however, it is helpful when you are doing audio scanning to do so. And linking messages you do not have to do, but it's also an available option here. So again, at this point, the most important part is saving the board, or saving the message cell. So we'll hit the upper right hand arrow, and as you can see, it gives us the ability to go back and create more cells, or we can look at the cells that are currently created. Now what we'll want to do is hit the upper right hand arrow, and that will actually save all of the information that's been entered into the message board. And as you can see now, we have our user created board that we've done just now, and then also preloaded boards that are currently existing in the iPad. Now to go back and edit that board that you've just created, you'd tap here, and then you can interact with that board and go back through the same process. But as far as creating a board, that is the basics that will get you up and running with SoundingBoard. If you have any questions or comments, please let us know in tech support. Our phone number is 800-322-0956, and you'll just want to pick the tech support option. or you can email us at techsupport@ablenetinc.com. Thanks for watching, and have a good day.